use cities as my inspiration, but I'm looking at the structures and spaces within those cities. Travel is a big part of my inspiration, especially when it comes to color. Seasons as well play a lot into, you can tell through the seasons what colors I'm using. If it's hot, I'm using those bright yellows and bright pinks along with the muted whites and blacks. When I travel, I keep a little sketch journal and I make notes of where I've been and I draw little maps, and those little quadrants come into play later when I'm thinking about the shapes of the buildings and how things interact. I work in layers a lot, so it'll start off with a wash of color on the canvas, which will have nothing to do with the final color. I like to have that big bold bit of color underneath because it will come through in just little hints. And then it's just building up thin layers, you know, and then thicker and thicker, using glazes in between layers of paint to let things bounce around and play. I like the paint to do the talking. I like there to be a little bit of texture, and I like that play when I'm painting. I like you to be able to feel that this is a painting. It's not a photograph. It's not a graphic printed piece. It's a painting. I want people to feel a little challenged when they look at it, because even though it is based on landscape and city environments, there's nothing really about it that says this is a building, this is a streetscape. It's reduced to its most minimal for me. And I want them to feel, I don't know, maybe a little thrown by it, but at the same time going, wow, okay, this is kind of neat. I like what she's doing with the paint. I like what she's doing with color and composition. And I want them, you know, to like it ultimately.